next line down. Reversible, fourth one. Reversible adiabatic. Reversible adiabatic. Adiabatic process, delta Q is equals to what?
Zero.
Expansion means work done by the system, negative. So expression of float we can write first of thermodynamics. Delta U is equals to what? Q plus W. Work done by the system. So when Q is equals to zero, delta U is equals to what? Equals to the work done. Right, and this is what, this is work done by the system, right? So work done is negative, it means delta U is what? See, you can understand this very easily. You have a system, right? Now process is adiabatic, so it cannot exchange energy with the surroundings. So whenever it does work, it works on the cost of its own energy, right? So in this process, what happens? The internal energy, right, on internal energy of the system decreases, or the system does work at the cost of its internal energy or its own energy. So internal energy decreases in this process, and when internal energy decreases, temperature also decreases in this. Temperature of the system also decreases.
Why is internal energy decrease?
Because the system is adiabatic process we have, so it cannot exchange energy with the surroundings. Energy exchange is not possible. And if it is doing work, it means it does work on the cost of its own energy. That is internal energy. That's why internal energy decreases. Correct? Temperature also decreases.
So when you expand, you do work.
Yes. System does work. So it's work done by the system. When it compresses, you're working on the system.
So what is delta U as a function?
Yes, it is.
No. What is the function?
It is actually, there are two things. Delta U is directly proportional to temperature.
Yes, more, what is the exact function?
See, that you, there is a two, three things. Like I said, I won't go into that detail. Internal energy is a function of kinetic energy, potential energy, and the chemical energy, correct? Kinetic energy is a function of temperature, and this is a function of the position, right? And that affects the volume of the system, right? So U is a function of temperature and volume, that you can say.
And it's directly proportional.
Directly proportional for temperature, you can say.
So is it directly proportional to volume?
Volume we are not considering, because it depends upon the relative position of the molecules.
Yeah, so is it very close, then there's more
repulsion,
and it's very far, there's more
attraction. That's why it is, right? But it is directly proportional to temperature, you can say that. Okay? Temperature is more, kinetic energy is more, so more energy will be there. That's how it is. Okay, but this is again not required. Okay, so
when you say internal energy decreases, but delta U means final minus initial. So if work is done, final it should be more than initial.
System is doing work. No. Work, that's why I say work is negative here. It is coming negative, it is work done by the system. Right? Now in this del U we have done last class, del U is equals to Cv delta T. Right? So work done, what we can write in this process? Work done is equals to delta U, and delta U is equals to Cv delta T. Right? Cv delta T. For one mole, right? N is equals to 1. And work done, again, like I said, we can always write this as minus P external into delta V. Work done is this. So this should be equals to what? Cv delta T, right? For very small change, what we can write? Very small change, we can write minus P external dV is equals to Cv dT. Delta T is for finite change, right? For very small change, we'll write D, derivative, dV, dT, dx, like that. Okay? Now the process is what? Reversible. So this is not constant. right? So what we can write this as? Minus RT by V for one mode. You can take n is equals to any value, but generally we derive it for n is equals to 1. If you take n over there, then this is equals to n C V delta T.
Yes. It will become n.
Here the n and n will get cancelled. N C V delta T and RT by V. So here it will get cancelled.
So it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter in this case.
Isn't Q equal to
C V
delta T?
Q is equals how?
Isn't that
the
formula for Q?
CP delta T, that is, not CV. Check your notes. And that is Q, that is not Q, that is H. DH is equals to NCP delta T. You check your notes, enthalpy.
Sir, CV is specifically capacity
at constant volume. But it is,
but we're equating it with the change in volume.
No, but this CV we can use for any process. It is not required that volume should be constant. CV and CP we can write for any process.
But sir, if we derive it using the assumption.
No, that is not the actual thing. We can actually derive delta H from, like I said, no, potential energy, kinetic energy, and then internal pressure we neglect over there. Then we'll get du is equal to NCV delta T. That is the actual derivation. The simpler one is what? CP and specific heat capacity for one mole, we'll write CP and CV at constant pressure and constant volume. And then what we write? At constant volume C. The C will write as CP and CV. This is at constant volume, right? So when volume is constant, work done is zero. So delta U is equals to what? Q, right? So C is equals to what we can write? dQ by dT. This is the formula of heat capacity, right? So in constant volume, we have Q becomes delta U. So this CV becomes what? Instead of Q, we'll write U, so dU by dT. This is a simple derivation, but from this derivation, you don't have the idea of this thing, it is applicable for all the process. The actual derivation is the one that we did last class, where we have internal pressure we assume to be zero, and ideal gas we are assuming, where there is no internal pressure. You check your notes, I have given you that U relation, KEP plus chemical energy.
Yeah.
I have partial derivative kiya that do wala term. Right? So, wahan if you see, for ideal gas, it is CV, and it is applicable for all the process. Right? Whether the volume is constant or not. CP also you can write for all the process, whether the pressure is constant or not. Okay? This you must take care of, CP and CV. You can use this expression for any process, whether volume or pressure is constant or not. Right? Simpler derivation is this. But from this, you don't understand why CP and CV is applicable for all the process. Right? So that's the thing. So nRT by V for one mole we have here. Here we have dV, and that is equals to CV dT here. Can you do the integration here? Kar sakte kya? This dV and V will write together, and dT and T will write together. Right? So the integral expression is what? Minus R dV by V is equals to CV dT by T. So integrate from that. Suppose when the temperature is T1, volume is V1, temperature is T2, volume is V2. Integrate, you can find out the relation of V and T. Where? T I wrote here, and V to this T I wrote here, dT by T. Have you done that PV to the power of gamma constant?
Yeah.
Adiabatic process, PV to the power gamma. Derivation you did?
No.
So derivation, you can derive it from here, PV to the power gamma constant. Solve this. Done. What is the relation of V and T? Then?
It's equal to C V ln of T2 by T1.
Then?
That's all right.
You can solve, no? Ln and ln, you can cancel out both sides. Do some rearrangement here and there and you can solve that. See, you have the relation. No. It's not, you don't understand things. Point is, obviously when R, ln you have, you cannot cancel ln directly. But R you can put there in the power. Ln y to the power x, x ln y. And then you can remove ln. Simple simplification. See, this term is what? Minus R ln V2 by V1, okay? And right hand side we have CV ln. CV ln T2 by T1. Okay. Now you see R, CV by R, what we can write CV by R? CV by R, what is CV by R? Tell me.
1 by gamma minus
1. 1 by gamma minus 1. अभी मैंने किया है CV का formula. Right? So CV by R is 1 by gamma minus 1. This is minus. Minus of ln. Or can we write this ln V1 by V2? 1 by gamma minus 1 ln T2 by T1. Right? Further, can we write this ln V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1 is equals to ln T2 by T1? Can we do this? Okay. Gamma minus 1 will have here, and then this will be the power of this. So we'll have this expression. Clear?
So what
is the last? Gamma minus 1 we can multiply here, and this we can write here as the power of this. So ln V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1 is equals to ln T2 by T. CV by R is 1 by gamma minus
1.
What is the formula of CV? CV is equals to R by gamma minus 1. Just now we did this. So CV by R is what? 1 by gamma minus 1. Okay? Now, further can we write this as V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1 is equals to T2 by T1. If you cross multiply this, what we get? T1 by V1 to the power gamma minus 1, T2 V2 to the power gamma minus 1, and can we write this in adiabatic process, TV to the power gamma minus 1 is equals to constant. Right?
Sir, but this is expression for work done.
Hmm?
Doing work done.
Right? No, work done we'll do. Just we have done this expression, work done also we'll do. Work done expression is very simple. It's two. Clear this one?
Yeah.
Now, can we represent this temperature in terms of pressure and volume? So, T if I write down here, PV by R for one mole, V to the power gamma minus 1 is equals to constant. R is already a constant, so V into this becomes what? PV to the power gamma is equals to constant. Right? So we have TV expression, we have PV. Now what we need to find out? PT, correct? So for PT, this V we write it as R T by P to the power gamma is equals to constant. So what we can write? P to the power one minus gamma T to the power gamma is equals to constant.
Suppose
N moles will get cancelled here because both sides we have N mole then. It will get cancelled. Right? This we can also write it as P to the power, P into T to the power gamma by 1 minus gamma is equals to constant. This is also we can. So all these three expressions is important for adiabatic process. They can ask you any one of the expressions. So if you remember PV to the power gamma or PT you need to find out, just substitute volume. Okay. PT to the power gamma by 1 minus gamma. See, both sides, this side is a constant. If you take the power of 1 by 1 minus gamma, we'll have some constant value this side. And this becomes gamma by 1 minus gamma and this will get cancelled. So sometimes they also give you this expression. P 1 minus gamma by gamma into T is equals to constant. They can give you this also. Right? So this is also adiabatic process. So any of this expression they can give you. Understood this? Now you see the work done expression is very easy here. Work done is equals to what? CV delta T. Okay? And that further we can write Cv into T2 minus T1 delta T. T2 minus T1 we can write P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by R for one more. Fine. Okay. This becomes what? R is Cp minus Cv into P2 V2 minus P1 V1. If you divide this Cv here, it becomes P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by gamma minus 1. Expression for work done in adiabatic process. Okay, this is the expression for work done. P2 V2 minus P1 V1 by gamma minus 1. Directly also you can write Cv by R is 1 by gamma minus 1. That is also you can write. Okay. Isothermal. And adiabatic. What is the graph of isothermal process? PV graph. Like this. Okay. Further at another temperature. Okay. At three different temperatures, suppose T1, T2 and T3. Okay, graph of adiabatic process, PV graph, will be like this. Okay, it is also same, right? So if the graph is given like this, it is difficult to identify which one is isothermal. Suppose only one graph you assume, this two, let it be. This graph, the nature is exactly same, right? So it's difficult to differentiate the two graphs, right? Which one is adiabatic, which one is isothermal. So how do we understand this that we are going to understand now? Suppose this isothermal process, we have PV is equals to what? Constant. We'll try to compare the slope of this two graph. Okay? PV is equals to constant. What is the slope of this graph? That will be dP by dV. What is the slope of this graph? Again, dP by dV. So we'll try to find out the expression of dP by dV in both the process. Correct? So, when you differentiate this, it becomes dP by dV is equals to some constant k divided by v square minus 1 by v ka differentiation minus 1 by v square. Okay. And this constant we are assuming as k. So, k we can write as p into v. Right? So this becomes what? Minus PV by V square. So dP by dV is equals to what? Minus P by V. This is very important. Okay? This is very important for exams. Not for the school exams. Right? dP by dV, the process, sorry, the graph, the slope of isothermal curve is minus P by V. Now here, what is the equation for adiabatic process? PV to the power? Gamma is equals to constant, and remember gamma is greater than 1, right? Gamma is greater than 1. So when you differentiate this dP by dV, what is the expression we get here? Can you tell me? Suppose we constant k we have here.
Minus gamma minus k into minus gamma divided by
v to the power
minus
gamma minus
1 by gamma plus
1. Okay. So this we can write it as minus k into gamma, or if I take this down, it becomes v to the power gamma into V. Okay? And K we can write PV to the power gamma. Again, this K is what? PV to the power gamma. So this becomes minus gamma. K is PV to the power gamma divided by V to the power gamma into V. So this will get cancelled. V to the power gamma, V to the power gamma. Slope of this graph will be what? dP by dV is minus of gamma times P by P, correct? Is it 5? Okay. Minus P by V is what? Slope of isothermal process. So can we write this? The slope of adiabatic process is equals to gamma times the slope of isothermal process, right? And gamma is greater than 1, so slope of adiabatic process is more than the slope of isothermal process. This is right now. Slope of adiabatic process what happened? Huh? This is very important. If the graphs are given, you can compare the slope and say which one is adiabatic, which one is isothermal.
Values, right? Because still, like, just by looking
at just one point, see, at just one point, first I'll tell you what to do, just give me 2 more minutes, you understand, okay? At one point you try to draw a line, right? At the same point, which one has higher slope, that will be adiabatic. For one point, suppose we have two graphs like this, no? So, यहाँ पे हम लोग इसके लिए suppose we have one more line like this, of course, ठीक है?
Yes.
So, हम लोग यहाँ पे ऐसे slope draw कर सकते हैं, इसका slope ऐसा हो जाएगा कुछ. So the one which has higher angle, more slope, but other way also, we'll see that, what to do. One thing is very important here, the first thing is slope of adiabatic process is more than isothermal, very important. Second very important point, suppose if this graph is given, nothing is mentioned, adiabatic, isothermal, and there are some information, right? So how do we identify that which one is adiabatic and isothermal? So first of all, isothermal graph never intersects, wo parallel hoga. Right? But adiabatic graph will go like this. This is at one temperature T1, this is another T2, and at another temperature it will go like this. So adiabatic graph intersects at one point, but isothermal graph does not intersect. Okay, this is one very important point. Okay, so when you have graph like this, or this, this one is obviously isothermal, and this one is adiabatic. Okay, so don't get confused with this. Right.
How would things with different temperatures have the same pressure?
So what happens?
This graph. Yeah. We'll discuss that. First of all, you see, this is C. First of all, PV to the power gamma constant, right? PV gamma constant. PV is constant for this one. So when you have different temperature, obviously this product will also be different. Right? That's why we are getting different graph here. Right? But PV to the power gamma, at 3 different temperature, if you try to draw a slope, we'll get a point where the slope is same for all the graph at different temperature. That's why it means that it intersects at one point at some values, right? Now to differentiate this thing, you have to keep in mind that isothermal graph never intersects, adiabatic intersects at one point. But again, if you have like this, I'll draw the graph first, you copy it on this, we'll see how the question comes into this. Done this one?
So I show the differentiation correct.
Huh? I think it is correct. X to the power n का डिफरेंशियल क्या होगा? NH to the power n minus 1.
But isn't it constant by V? Huh? Isn't it constant by V?
By V? I know that volume is V. See, this V is equal to what? K by V to the power gamma, yeah, no? Now, dP by dV if you write, so ये क्या हो जाएगा? K V to the power minus gamma का डिफरेंशिएशन होगा ना? So, ठीक है, तो ये हो जाएगा माइनस गामा v टू द पावर माइनस गामा माइनस 1 nx टू द पावर n माइनस 1 whatever you do you'll get this one. Okay. You do it. You get it. Okay. Now you see this graph. We are considering expansion first of all. We need to find out which one is isothermal graph and which one is adiabatic graph.
So this one is adiabatic.
Huh?
This one is adiabatic.
No, in this one, see, isothermal.
What is isothermal?
This is isothermal, suppose. Adiabatic also goes like this somehow. So which one is adiabatic, which one is isothermal?
So the
slow.
More slow.
So the one on top is adiabatic.
No.
Let me explain this. There are two possibilities in this. Wait. There are two possibilities in this. One is case one, when final pressure is same, PF. Right? Case one is when final pressure is same. Okay, case 2, when final volume is same. When final volume is same, so it will go like this. VF. Expansion, so this is the problem. Okay, final pressure and final volume is same. Okay, it's B right now. Okay, now in adiabatic process you see what happens. I'm talking about this now. Adiabatic process. It is expansion, right? The volume is increasing. Expansion. It means work done by the system, right? Adiabatic process, work done by the system. Internal energy decreases. Means what? Temperature decreases. Temperature decreases means what? The final volume also? PV to the power gamma constant. Right? Final pressure is same, temperature is decreasing, right? It means the volume should decrease or increase. Volume should decrease. Adiabatic U decreases, temperature decreases. Temperature is decreasing, no? So volume should decrease.
So what is expansion?
So what? See, what we are trying to understand whether this graph is isothermal or this graph is isothermal. Or this is adiabatic or this one is adiabatic. So first we are considering what? Adiabatic process, internal energy decreases, temperature decreases. So PV is equals to nRT, pressure is same, so volume should decrease to maintain the ideal gas equation. Right? So final volume here we have lesser than the final volume here. So in adiabatic process, final volume should be lesser than the isothermal process. Right? So this one, this has the final volume here, and this is the final volume here. So this graph is what? This graph is adiabatic,
we will get it down.
Yeah, but the one on the left has normal slope, sir.
No, dude, look at the formula, it's minus, the slope should be minus.
Minus also we have to say.
So we can just use that formula.
And this is the, yeah, and this is the isothermal graph.
This one is greater without the minus.
Okay. So final volume in adiabatic process, VF in adiabatic process is lesser than VF in isothermal process. With the same logic you see here, if final volume is same, this is the final pressure for one of the process and final pressure is this.
The lesser final pressure should be adiabatic.
Same logic. Here the volume is constant, so pressure should decrease.
Oh, so you can't say that pressure and volume are in
one. No, because one of the thing is constant. Either volume is constant or pressure is constant.
Okay.
So temperature will decrease in adiabatic process. Again, volume is constant, so pressure should also decrease. Right? So this pressure is lesser than this, so this graph is what? Adiabatic, and this one is isothermal. So the lower one is always adiabatic, you see. Right?